My brother and I really like watching shows and movies about criminals, like Escobar and Narcos. We find them to be really cool and interesting shows to watch, please don't kill me, and it got me wondering, what are some of the most dangerous cartels in human history? So we will talk about some of their leaders, where they came from, how much money they might have, and their worst crimes against humanity. The Sinaloa Cartel. The current leader is unclear due to the secretive nature of the organization, but notable figures like Ismael El Mayo Zambada and Rafael Caro Quintero have been associated with it. The Sinaloa Cartel originated in the state of Sinaloa, Mexico. Sadly, I won't be able to tell you how much money most of these cartels have because it is difficult to estimate their exact wealth. But they are considered one of the wealthiest and most powerful cartels in Mexico, with revenues estimated in the billions of dollars. And to gain this money, they involve themselves in drug trafficking, particularly heroin and cocaine, but also involved in other criminal activities such as money laundering, extortion, and murder. No surprise there. The Sinaloa Cartel has been involved in numerous acts of violence, including high-profile assassinations, and is infamous for its ruthlessness in maintaining control over its territory. Despite the capture of its former leader, El Chapo, the Sinaloa Cartel remains active, albeit facing challenges from rival cartels and law enforcement. Medellín Cartel. We should all know by now that their most notorious leader was Pablo Escobar, based in Medellín, Colombia. At its peak, the Medellín Cartel was one of the wealthiest criminal organizations globally, earning billions of dollars annually. Initially focused on smuggling emeralds, it later became infamous for cocaine trafficking and associated crimes like money laundering, bribery, and violence. Some of Medellín's most notorious crimes involve Pablo Escobar's bombing campaign in Colombia, including the bombing of Flight 203, stands out as one of the most notorious acts attributed to the cartel. Because, you know, practically starting a civil war in your own country makes you a pretty scary organization. The Medellín Cartel disbanded in the 1990s, following the death or imprisonment of many of its key members, including Pablo Escobar. Gulf Cartel. Though the current leadership is uncertain, where they came from isn't. Originating in this area in Mexico, the cartel is believed to have significant financial resources, but precise estimates are challenging due to the secretive nature of their operations. Because, of course they are. Involved in drug trafficking, human trafficking, extortion, and other criminal activities, you know, just the run-of-the-mill crimes for a cartel, the Gulf Cartel has been involved in numerous violent incidents, including clashes with rival cartels and law enforcement. The Gulf Cartel remains active, although it faced internal struggles and challenges from rival cartels. Los Zetas. Again, the current leadership is uncertain, but it was initially formed by deserters from the Mexican Special Forces, who joined the Gulf Cartel. Los Zetas are believed to be financially powerful, just like most cartels, with revenues from drug trafficking, extortion, and other criminal enterprises. They act like a paramilitary force. Los Zetas are infamous for their extreme violence, including mass killings, beheadings, and brutal tactics to control territory and intimidate rivals. Jesus. Despite facing pressure from law enforcement, Los Zetas remains active, though they have fragmented into smaller factions. Juarez Cartel. Again, the leader is uncertain. What, brave enough to commit crimes but not brave enough to show yourself? I'm joking, please don't kill me. Based in Ciudad Juarez, Mexico, the exact wealth of the Juarez Cartel is difficult to estimate, but it has been a significant player in drug trade for decades, which means they have a lot of money. Involved in drug trafficking, human trafficking, kidnapping, extortion, and other criminal activities, the cartel has been involved in numerous violent incidents, including high-profile assassinations and clashes with rival cartels, and law enforcement, of course, can't forget about them. And the Juarez Cartel remains active, though it has faced internal conflicts and challenges from rival cartels. Last up, we have the Mexican government. I hope all of you enjoyed watching my video, and that it serves as a reminder to stay far away from crime, and to keep criminal activities on your flat-screen TV. If you did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in another episode.